You can see here the questions. That is saying, is it visible? Is it visible?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
And now?
Yes, sir.
So the first question says,
yes, sir.
First question says,
yes, sir.
This type of sums you have done already, but I'll repeat this because these are the basics. That was Shashwato and Suraj, please take them seriously. Others, all of you have done this. Even Shashwato could do it and Suraj also could do it. But in during class, I remember, normal classes, I discussed this type of sum, quite huge gap. So it may miss from your brain. So I'm discussing question number one. Suppose say, I want to discuss question number one, which says that what is the ratio of the of velocity to speed. Now velocity, what is velocity? First you have to understand speed and velocity has good difference. That velocity is defined, we have particular direction. So the chapter, you remember 1g of this chapter, 2g of this chapter, 3g of this chapter, and we also have 4g, I guess. But 1g is distance and displacement, if you remember this, right? Switch on your mic, please. You are just 4 present today, so mic is not a problem for me. Displacement and distance, these two things you know. We divide this by time, we get, for displacement if we divide, we get velocity. Divide by time, we get velocity. And when we divide distance by time, I think so, I must write it clearly to avoid your confusion. Distance, this is the first one is displacement and second one is distance. So this is my distance. Distance by time is speed. So this is a vector quantity, displacement having particular direction. Well, this is not a vector quantity. Similarly, velocity is a vector quantity, but speed is not. Speed has got no direction. So one thing is very much sure. If you have a point A, Shashwato and Suraj, try to understand. I am not bothered for others because you both are here and some doubts you had, I remember, in this topic. If you have A and B and A is moving from B, one direction can be this, another it can move like this also, another it can be like this also. All are possible and all are distance between A and B, but A and B, this is shortest possible distance, this one, the one I am drawing in blue color now, I am intentionally drawing in blue color. This is shortest possible distance. By saying shortest possible distance, what do you mean? You mean to say that this is having particular direction. So this displacement will lead to velocity. Now remember, displacement is also a type of distance only, but shortest, the definition itself says shortest possible distance is displacement. That means this is also bigger than this, this is also bigger than this, or any other path will be also bigger than this. So instead of asking the question, they are saying ratio of velocity to speed. If I take velocity to speed like this, that is equal to, very simple, you can say this, for this velocity you say displacement, you call it displacement by time, and for this you will say distance by time. Distance by time, that means this can be rewritten as, I can try to write this as distance, this is equal to displacement, I write displacement by time, into, this gets reversed, time by distance. Time cancels. So in summary, you can say velocity by speed is equal to displacement by, I'll write full, displacement by distance. Now the story starts. You have done this much. Now you can say, is there any chance that displacement will be, displacement is this one, is there any chance that this will be bigger than any distance? You answer me. Switch on your mic and answer me, please. Answer me, please. Answer me, please. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
All of you switch on your mic, no problem in that. Just four of you are here. It's very comfortable, no problem. We belong to same society. If and you are at home, if some noise comes, it doesn't matter much. I'm not from London. I'm from here only. It doesn't matter. We are from social background, same social background. So it hardly matters. All of you switch on your mic. Pankaj did it. What about Shashwat and Suraj did it? Manas and Shashwat, what about you all? All of you switch. Shashwat, where are you?
Sir.
Okay, fine. Manas mic is on. What about Shashwat? Switch on the mic.
Sir, your voice is not clear.
That's what I want to see. Listen to your voice. Switch on the mic.
Yes, sir. Your voice is not clear.
Then why didn't you say me earlier? Yeah?
Sir, now it is not clear. Before it was clear.
Switch on the mic, Shashwato. I am writing also. It may happen the system. One of my students said me previously, he is in KV. He said me, sir, actually we just switch on the classes and we mute it and we just do our work. But this is said for the nonsense classes. I think so my classes are not so nonsense because students normally take some benefit of the classes. If you are not able to take the benefit, then you are losers. There is no doubt in it. Fine. Now the question comes, Shashwat is not here, he is missing. All other three are present. Shashwat is sleeping. Shashwat, our main target is not Manas and Pankaj. Suraj is there continuously live. Shashwat, where are you? Where are you? Switch on the mic. Switch on the mic. Keep your mic on. Keep your mic on.
Yes, sir.
Keep your mic on. Now, what about the problem, what I discussed? You explain me. Explain me the problem. Displacement and distance. Now it's clear? Problem may be in your side. Tell me one thing. Okay. Let me stop.
Sir, your voice is not clear.
How many apps you have in your mobile? How many apps you have in your mobile?
I don't
know. Huh? I'm typing. Fine, no problem. You can type or say me. I have typed in the chat box. How many apps you have in the mobile? Let me ask you some question today, because this will be going to serious problem during examination, especially. Okay. Can you see my questions in the chat box? Answer me. You write down. I'm with some purpose I am doing this. If mobile is creating problem, like Shashwat's mobile network problem continuously reports that, in that case I can help you. I can make entry in your mobile and then see the problem, what actually is happening inside, and repair it. Do it okay. Because you are suffering. You are suffering with your mobile a lot. Fine. Pankaj is doing laptop, so there will be no problem. And mostly I have seen he is facing no problem. What about Banas and Suraj? You should be smart enough to find out your problems. Shashwat is continuously mic off. How do I know you are serious about your class? Shashwat, please switch on your video once. Quickly, switch on the video once. So 3GB RAM is not a matter of joke. It's quite huge. How many apps you have in your mobile? How many apps? Suraj? How many apps you have? Manas?
Apps are 30 apps.
What apps you have? How many game apps you have in your mobile?
Only
one. No game app in the mobile. Otherwise, I'll check your mobile. I have all means to get into your mobile and find out. You'll permit me. I'll discuss with your parents in that case, because this cannot be tolerated. No game apps in the mobile. 30 game apps, Suraj is writing. Then how do you expect your mobile will work properly? How many are game apps, Suraj? Some apps are required. Paytm and all you need. You cannot delete them. What about game apps? How many game apps you have? You can speak out also, Mike. I can hear you very clearly.
I have only one.
Huh? One. Delete game apps. You can play in... You can enjoy game in some other apps, some other mobile, but not in the one where you are doing your classes. Because game apps are going to consume huge, huge memory. And sometimes it remains on. Sometimes it remains on and that disturbs you. I experienced this with the junior class whom I am teaching computer craft, and many of them, not all, but at least out of 30, 4-5 of them say your voice is breaking. What I have seen so far, Pankaj is having very less problem. I didn't know the reason, but I thought his mobile is totally under control of his parents and he never misuses them. If
so, I don't have mobile.
Yes. Good, very good. Because in laptop you have better skin, but all of us, we cannot run for laptop immediately. So let's handle with mobile only very carefully. That is very important for us. If I take class like a machine, I sit here and keep discussing some problems. And yes, some system apps you cannot. That you have to. System apps you cannot touch also. They will remain. And 10 apps, if they have some unwanted apps, just get rid of them. Uninstall them immediately. Because your exams, you will be in trouble, let me tell you. And these marks will be counted. Board has given strong instructions. The normal online classes should be considered as normal class. There is no mercy. It is not that we are taking online class now because we are great, we want to help you, nothing like that. It's normal course class and normal class. Those who are absent here will be marked as absent and information will go to your parents, just like in normal class you are absent. So don't think that you are doing something extra, something excess, which is not wanted. This is your normal class, you are still now in school, you remember, as if this class is not over, you are still in school. You have to follow all the disciplines that of the school, of course with your parents handling, because we are physically not present there. So get rid of all game apps, and especially the no Chinese apps. It should be strictly TikTok, BikTok, everything should be immediately removed. There's no, they're being blocked, I think, so government has stopped them. And apart from this, some unwanted apps like PUBG. How many of you play PUBG? Suraj, do you play PUBG? Suraj, tell me honestly. Fine. No sir means good. Manas?
No sir.
Pankaj doesn't handle mobile. Now only left is Shashwat. So you tell me. Do you ever play PUBG? Yes sir. He is honestly saying at least yes sir. Stop it. It is addictive. Forcefully you stop this PUBG. If you don't, this is the only reason, Shashito, you are lagging behind. I have analyzed you fully. You are sharp and very intelligent. But where the problem is lying is only because of these diversions. Got my point? So get rid of this PUBG. If you really have affection for me, you respect your teacher, you respect me fully, then you leave it. No, not only 1-2 hours. It happens to be more time sometime. And moreover, your mobile cannot sustain that load. Sometime you switch off YouTube. Suppose you are listening to YouTube, you have to come out of it properly. Otherwise it will be on and your data is consumed, your memory is busy in that case, and you will be in trouble. So Shashwato, it's a challenge for you. Stop PUBG fully. You said me honestly, that is more than enough for me. And I believe you so much, the way you said me honestly, you play PUBG for 1 hour, 2 hours every day, so you can stop it also. You have that capacity, I know. So instead of running the class dry, dead and dry, giving you some information, if I don't go to the, no, all are addicted. PUBG is such a thing, any game actually, not only PUBG. All games, all are addicted.
I
think, if you're not addicted, don't play it for 10 days, till 30th July, take that, you won't touch also PUBG. Try and see. You'll find out whether you're addicted or not. You are getting chance every time. That's why you're playing. So you don't feel that you're addicted. Pankaj, I didn't ask you because I know you're under restrictions. You cannot play. There's no option, and I don't think so. You have attitude also. It should not be under pressure. Parents, you are grown up actually. It's not very wise that parents will run after you, check your mobile and see the way I'm seeing you now. I'll enter your mobile and see what are things inside. And all this stuff. This is nonsense actually. You are grown up. Once we discuss with you, once you know the problem, then you automatically realize yourself what is the problem. Game generally is good for concentration, but sometimes game makes you addicted. That is very dangerous. So in that case, I think so. And one more problem we are facing now is sometimes game is okay, I'm not against, but mobile will disturb you. My voice will be broken. You cannot attend your classes properly because of the apps in them. And some apps, as I told you, try to keep minimum apps. I have reduced everything in my mobile. There was an RTI apps in my mobile. Even Arogya Setu, I removed it recently. I removed it because I found it's not that useful. So without that, I can run my show. My main priority is the classes. So I cannot keep those apps which are of no use. Shashwat said very beautifully, 15 system apps. I'm very happy with this answer, and 10 installed apps. He is defined. He is very much aware of the apps, what is system apps and what is installed apps. Very nicely written. I'm feeling very happy with this. So you can handle the problem. Otherwise you'll face problem. Another thing, you should have some cleaning software. Android have their own cleaning software. So keep cleaning also sometime your mobile. Some junks are always there inside your mobile. That also make you incapable of listening to the voice clearly or seeing the video if it is required, and presentation paper, white paper and all, you cannot. So get rid of all this. Fine. You have to be very expert. Remember, you are with this COVID-19. The teachers and students are moving to new generation. I used to teach online last 2 years back onwards, and initially I faced huge problem in teaching online, but I was maybe destined and ready for teaching online, and even then I face it tough sometimes. And you know, teachers are struggling very hard. Some of the teachers are not comfortable in computers and they are struggling very hard to make the classes successful. And we are the only school in entire Silchar who is doing live classes even to junior classes, including KG classes. and we are the first people not only in Northeast but in whole India to start our classes, online classes. So how come you people will be tougher being our children? You have to be smart. We started our class on 28th April when nobody in India even started that, even thought of taking online classes. And we started on 28th April, remember this. So we have covered 3 chapters online, all during lockdown time. And I think so your concepts are not so poor in that. Is it poor? Still you have doubts? So if you have doubts, even I have doubts in the chapters, that much doubt whole life we bear in physics. Fine. So there's always chance of improvement. And Shashwat, switch on your mic. Why your mic is off? Why you bothered for mic? Switch on your mic, Shashwat. Switch on your mic. Shashwat, switch on your mic. Yes, that's better. No problem, that some sound comes, no problem in that. So I want to continue to the numericals again. The same page I'll share and you'll ask me your doubts. The first problem is this: in the page you found velocity by speed is equal to displacement by distance. Now see the diagram. Is there any chance I'm sharing it now? We'll see again. Is there any chance? Now I'm sharing it. Is it visible? Is it visible? Shashwat, is it visible? Not yet. I think now it will be. Now it will be visible. So, what we can see here, displacement by distance. There, listen carefully. This is the only thing I'll do and conclude today because others are not present. One thing I'll discuss here. Displacement and distance. There is no chance that displacement will be bigger than distance. This is blue one is displacement. It will be never bigger than distance, remember. It will never, never, never bigger than distance. But my point, displacement will be never bigger than distance, first point. Second point, in some case, displacement can be equal to distance. So, if displacement is equal to distance, this will become 1, and when displacement is always less than distance, it can be equal or less, it will be never bigger. Because definition of displacement itself is saying it's the shortest possible distance. So how can it will be bigger than distance? Never. So this value will be, the lower one will be always bigger, so velocity by speed will be always, velocity by speed will be always equal to either greater than this value, is it will be either less than 1 or equal to 1. Equal to 1 when displacement is equal to distance, this will be 1, so velocity will be equal to speed. But in normal cases, distance is always bigger than displacement. So this is bigger means this, the net value here will be less than 1, it will be less than 1 always. Is this part clear? Is this concept clear? This will be less than 1 always. That means velocity by speed is always, it can be less than 1 or maximum it can be equal to 1. Am I clear? If not clear, please tell me. This concept should be very much clear to you all. Is it clear? Is it clear? Yes. If it is clear, Shashwat, is it clear?
Yes.
Shashwato, is it clear? Shashwato, is it clear? Shashwato, is it clear? Fine. Then why don't you switch on your mic? Anyway, now that means you get the other one, second question. If I go to second question, they are saying you, what is the ratio of distance to displacement? Just reverse of this. So here you talk about distance to displacement. I don't need to explain this again. Here you talk about distance to displacement. This is reverse. So this will be always, see, distance can be equal to displacement. So this, in that case, it will be equal to 1. It will be equal to 1. And in most of the cases, displacement will be smaller. So it will be always greater than or equal to 1. Am I clear? Am I clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So, ultimately you talk about two numericals at one go, distance and displacement. In class, I remember, I discussed this in details. And some of you could easily understand this, but there can be doubt arising. This type of critical questions and complicated type of questions can be asked, not directly these questions, but it can be twisted in such a way that you are able to answer them. If fundamentals are clear, then you can easily answer them. Now I'll go to, as Dipayan also has arrived, unfortunately too early for next class and too late for this class, and I'll go to the other question. Let me cover this, because there's hundreds of numericals we have discussed, hundreds of topics we have discussed. This numerical also we did in class, and I give you assignment, and James did it very quickly. I remember James and Devraj could do it very quickly. Question says, a man travels half length of a straight road. Listen carefully. Question number 3. Half length of a straight road. Half length, this is half approximately. Straight road with a constant speed of 20 meter per second. 20 meter per second. And he travels second half of the road with a constant speed of 60 meter per second. I'm writing like traditional way, meter per second. Then calculate average speed. Nothing else is given. Only they said half of the road is this and half of the road. So velocity is given and distance is not given directly. So let me consider this length to be L. The whole length to be L. So this is L by 2. From here to here it is L by 2. And this is also L by 2. See the method, I am solving it. And you have formula, S equal to Vt. S equal to velocity into time. So you have velocity here as V1 and velocity here as V2, which is given actually. So time you can measure, time is not known to you. So distance here is L by 2 in first case for this. L by 2, 20 into T. So T is equal to, you can say from this, T is equal to L by 40. Similarly, I can also find out, this is T1 suppose, say. I name it T1. Here we have T1 for this and here we have T2. And similarly, I can find out T2, which is equal to L by 60. Am I clear? Seconds. Unit also you mentioned, second. Second. So time is not known in terms of L. Now, average velocity is equal to total distance by total time. Total distance by total time. Time. So total distance here is L. L by 2 plus L by 2 L. I have considered this. And total time is L by 40 plus L by 60. Any objection? Now let me take LCM of this below. 60 and 40, how much will be the LCM? How, this is up here, L. How much will be the LCM? 60 and 40? Quickly do it. You do along with me. Am I right? This will remain 15. So let me not come to this. Let me not come to this. How much is the value? Is 150. 150 and 4. How much is 150 and 4 together makes? 60? 60? Right? How much is this? How much is this? Quickly tell me, please. How much is LCM of 40 and 60? Quick, please, quick. I made the LCM like a junior class student, class 6 student. This is 20, 30, 10, and then this remains 10 and 15. This can go by 5. And this becomes 2, this becomes 3. So LCM will be 6 and 5, 30. 30, this is 30. 6, LCM, you know how to make LCM? Switch on your mic and answer me, please. 3 and 2, 6. 6 and 5, 60, 30. 30 and 2, 60. 60 and 120, this becomes 120. So you have LCM 120. If it is 120, this becomes 60L plus 40L. So this answer will be like this. Here you get L into 120. Divided by how much is this 100L? Right? 60 and 40 is 100. 100L, LL goes. What you are left with? 00 goes. It's 1 point. Something wrong I have done. Some mistake has been done. You find out the mistake, please. Is it correct? Is it correct? All mics are off. All mics are off. Simply off. And there can be WhatsApp talks going on. Because you are not answering me. You are not at all answering me.